the Founders Award.
Thank you. Good evening. It's lovely to be here. Ryan Murphy, I mean, I think we are all familiar with his wild success for his programs that have kind of changed the face of television. Glee, Nip Tuck, New Normal, the one I'm personally deeply involved with, American Horror Story, which last year received 17 Emmy nominations, which was quite extraordinary. But I think what we do recognize about Ryan is that he has an uncanny intuition. He has an instinctive appreciation or understanding of the current zeitgeist and acts on it in a way that to me is startling sometimes. Just when I think, oh my God, we have gone so over the top here, it never ceases to amaze me that, you know, there's something current in the press that trumps us all the time. I mean, it is quite a gift. He is generous, he is inventive, he has a wicked sense of humor, and what I think of as a somewhat askew imagination, which I find endearing and thrilling to be around. He says things to me that very few creative directors, writers have said. What haven't you played? What would you like to play? What have you always wanted to do? And sometimes, just to be perverse, I say things like, because I'm not a singer, I want to sing, or I want to dance. And somehow, as far-fetched as that is, he can amazingly come up with something and somehow create a musical number that's filled with joy that is played out in an asylum for the criminally insane. And somehow he makes it work, and not only does he make it work and not sound in the least bit camp, but he finds the truth emotionally within that moment. So I congratulate him tonight. I also want to say that I think of him as a dear and loyal friend, somebody that you can confide in your most hidden torments and never be embarrassed by. And when he says to me, which he does more often than I would like to admit, "Oh, lady, why aren't you happier?" I know he genuinely means it. He's concerned, and he actually does care how I answer that question. And now it is my honor to present the 2012 International Emmy Founders Award to Ryan Murphy.
One of the reasons I am so honored and thrilled to be honored tonight is because I am in the presence of my idol and the biggest shaper of my ideological life, Mr. Norman Lear, who is at my table. Thank you. When I was 7, after much persistent begging and pleading, my parents finally let me watch an episode of All in the Family, which was the topic of conversation at my Catholic grade school, St. Simon's. And even the nuns were hooked on the show. So they let me watch it, and the episode was the now classic Edith almost gets raped episode. So you can imagine my poor parents. I remember watching and crying and worrying about Edith. And afterwards, it launched a real discussion in my household about women and women's rights, sex, my poor father, class. And the impact it had on me was indelible. 40 years later, and here I am in the same room with the man who created that show, and it's a real moment for me. And I don't think I possess the brilliance of Norman, and I know this for sure because today on Twitter, one of my followers, Bitter Candy Apple, wrote to me, "Asshole, you are no Norman Lear." But I've tried to make him proud by attempting in my 5 television shows thus far to be as brave as he was in shining a spotlight on the topics of tolerance and human rights. The impact of television is so powerful, and I never, ever take it for granted. I know this because every week I am contacted by young people vis-a-vis social media, who say, for example, how Kurt Hummel coming out to his father on Glee helped them have the strength to talk to their parents about their sexuality, or how the couple on The New Normal, who weekly confront bigotry in their attempt to have a family, gives them inspiration to fight for everyone's right to love as they see fit. The amazing thing to me about my career is that I went into it thinking that writing about social injustice was going to be very, very difficult. Difficult to get funded, difficult to get by the censors, and I am shocked and thankful so far that this has not been the case. And I realize how lucky I am for that, and I think the only reason so much of my work gets on the air untinkered with and unfiltered is because of the love and support of my bosses who are here tonight, Dana Walden and Gary Newman of 20th Century Fox, who I know regularly think I am nuts, but support my visions nonetheless. And they are among the loveliest, smartest, and most visionary people working today, and I count myself so lucky to have found them so early on in my career. I dedicate this award to them and my selfless partner, David Miller. All three push me forward, support me, and yes, once in a blue moon, say, can you please, please tone it down just for once, please. I would like to thank also tonight my beloved Jessica Lange, who I have loved since God was a boy, and I'm so thankful she's giving me this tonight. I want to thank my team who was here, Kevin Uvain, Joe Cohen, and Craig Emanuel, and my wonderful producing partner, Dante DiLoretto, who I love very much. And in the end, again, there is Mr. Norman Lear. I asked him a couple of weeks ago, we were talking on the phone, if he had any advice for me, and he paused as he's wont to do, and he said simply, keep fighting. And Norman, I want to tell you I intend on doing just that in your honor. Thank you so much, and thank you to the Academy.